Hi everyone, in this video we will be parsing JSON containing arrays. Now we conquer a JSON structure that is similar to the one which we have done, but instead of just single value it might also have an array of values. As we can see in this JSON, a class is a similar key value pair as what we had done before, but the subject has an array of values which contains physics, chemistry, maths, which are values. It has a multiple values, that's why it's contained in a list or array. So for this we'll be making a class. So let's code. So I have already created array json.dot, and I have already written a JSON over here so that it's easier for us to see and code. In this we have class entity that has a simple string value, but the subject what we have, it has a value of list of string data type. So basically what we check once, the structure of the JSON. The structure of JSON is the map, basically, because since it starts with a curly braces and ends with a curly braces, so it's a map. It's not list of map. It does contain a value. It does contain a value which has a list of string data type, but it's just a map. So we'll write a class similar to what we have written before, like class, maybe student again. Student, then string, class, string, class. Class is a keyword, so we can use standard maybe. Then list of string, basically. Since the values physics, chemistry, maths are string and is contained in a list, so we have a list with a string data type, and we give value of it, this is subjects. You can give any names, but I prefer giving the same or similar names to what the JSON key has name. Now we will create a similar constructor. As these are the same step what we have done in the previous video, so I am not explaining much and focusing on coding. Start subject. Similarly, we will create a factory, use a factory keyword and create a function from JSON. Student class name dot from JSON. Map string comma dynamic JSON. Like in this JSON you might be clear like why we are using string dynamic data type over here. Like thus every time, it's not, we can't say we will have a string value. As we can see, the subjects, the entity, the subject has a value of list string data type. So we keep it as a dynamic, whatever it comes, the value, whatever it is, we will map it with the key. Okay, so the student dot from JSON, basically what it does, it will return full object, it will map everything and return the value. So we'll return, it returns the model over here, student. So student, sorry. Standard JSON class. Whatever name you give for your consideration, as I have written standard over here. Sorry, spelling mistake. Standard. As I have written standard over here, but when I am mapping it with the JSON, I need to use the key name. What it is, like class. Class is the key. I have written the string, the name of the, in the name in the model is standard, but I need to use the key what I am getting key from the server. So class is the key what server is giving it to me, and I have written, I will be storing that class value into a variable named standard. So I am mapping standard with the class basically. That's what I have done over here. Then subjects JSON subjects. Do you think like we are done with this? But we are not. The code which we have written, it works for the simple JSON. Right now we have a list of string data type. So basically when we run this code, we'll get an error. Let me show the error what we get when we run. So if we run that code, we'll get the type list dynamic is not a subtype for type list string. This is error which we will get. So what does it means basically? We are expecting a list string, but we get a list dynamic since the application cannot identify the type yet. So basically the Flutter, the framework doesn't identify like what type of value is coming. So it was expecting list string, but it got a value as list dynamic. So that's what we need to handle over here right now. So in this, what we'll do, like these type of errors, like I faced in a lot of time when I was doing my development. So it's pretty easy to handle once you get a hook of it. It's like pretty simple. Like you can create a variable name var. I'm not giving any data type over here. So we are using var over here. Standard basically, standard. No, subjects. Subjects from JSON is equals to JSON subjects. Here, first we are mapping our variable subjects from JSON to the subjects entity. But subject from JSON is still a list dynamic. Now we explicitly create a list of string. So right now we have just mapped the value of the value of JSON of subjects to a subjects from JSON. Now we will create a specific list string value. List string. String value. Subjects list. List. Will point to create new object list string dot from, and we will write right now what subjects from JSON. Subjects from JSON. Yeah, with this what we have done right now, first we are mapping our variable subjects from JSON to the JSON string subject entity. But still, the value of subjects from JSON is in list dynamic format. So then we create explicitly list string type. The list string, we have given the variable name subject list. That contains the element of the string from JSON. So what we have done, we have mapped values of subjects from JSON, which was in a list dynamic format, to a list string using from keyword. This is what from keyword does. It will take the values from subjects from JSON and store it in list of string as an array. And now we will change over here list of string. It will be subjects list. Perfect. Now if we will run, it won't give you any error. It will return. Basically, when we pass the value from student.from JSON, we'll pass the raw of JSON. We will get the model of the class. Okay, with this is how we get to know like how we can pass array of strings in the JSON format.